Hello everyone, welcome to this series of C tutorials. In this presentation, we will see how to break the software into multiple source files, finally compile and link the source file to get the final machine executable code. A program could be broken into functions. Next step is to break the program into multiple files. Some things we need to remember. Compilation happens in stages, and we need to compile source file in a particular well-ordered sequence. We will see this practically. Here I created two source files. One is 1.c and 2.c. In 2.c, I will define a variable named a, and I will give the value 10 in 2.c. Now come back to 1.c. Here I will declare the variable that we defined in some other program, that is 2.c. So we will use the extend keyword int a. We will print the value of a in the main function. Now we will compile two source files separately. First we will compile 2.c, gcc space hyphen 2.c. Next we will compile 1.c, gcc space hyphen c 1.c. Finally we will link both object codes and get the machine executable code. GCC space name of the first object code 1.o space name of the second object code 2.o space hyphen o name of the machine executable code. Here I will give final, then execute the machine executable code. We can see the output 10, that is the value of variable a that we defined in 2.c. In 1.c we declared the variable and we print the value of a. Make tool helps to optimize the build process of a software. Make tool could be used for any other languages. Not only for C, it could be used for any other language. Make command will look for a file called makefile or makefile. In the first case, M is small letter. In the second case, M is capital letter. Both are equivalent. We can use any of the name. In the makefile, we will specify certain set of rules. In order to get the final machine executable code, in this case we are going to follow certain set of rules. To write rules, we need to follow a syntax, that is, first we need to write the target followed by colon followed by dependency list, then the rule. We will see this practically, how we can make this work. We will delete previously generated object codes and machine executable code. We will create an empty file and we will name it as makefile. Here I am using small letter m. Open the makefile in a text editor. We will go from end product to the beginning of the source file. The end product is the machine executable code. The beginning things are the C source file. The compilation of C source file. The end product is, that is the machine executable code in this example, is final. This is the target colon followed by the dependency list. In order to get the machine executable code, we need object codes, that is 1.o and 2.o. These are our dependency list. Now the rule is we need to link these two files in order to get the final. To link, follow the command gcc space name of the first object code, name of the second object code, space hyphen o final. Now we need to get the machine executable code for the first C source file, that is 1.c. Our target is 1.o colon and the dependency is the source file, that is 1.c. The rule to compile 1.c is gcc space hyphen c name of the source file. The final dependency is 2.o. This is our target. 2.o is the target and the dependency is 2.c, that is the source file. We need source file to get the object code. Then the rule is gcc space hyphen c 2.c. We will save the program, open the folder, then open the virtual terminal. Just type in the command make. Here we got the first object code, second object code, and the final machine executable code. Run the program. Here we got 10. This video is presented by Avari Technologies. Please do hit subscribe button to get more content. Thank you.